Yo guys, what's up? Welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be showing you how to farm some Orokin cells, quick as possible, most efficient ways, pretty much. So there's a few nodes that are very good for this. I definitely recommend using a resource booster if you're farming anything, but if you don't have a resource booster, it's still the best spots to go. It makes no difference really. But yeah, so let me know, you guys are getting on with Warframe Octavia Prime releasing in a bit. You know, it's going to be a dub. But, so the best nodes on Saturn, which is where they mainly drop, is the boss node, Teddy's, or however you say it. That's a guaranteed drop when you kill the boss every time. So if you want to guarantee it, go there. Also, Helene and Titan are good farming spots if you want to stay in for a long amount of time. But my favorite farming spot for it is Gabby on Ceres, as it has an increased drop chance booster for the resources. So I definitely farm there if you want to stay in for a long amount of time. There or Helene, because the defense seems to drop it a lot more than Titan survival. So yeah, once you load in, I definitely recommend going straight to the boss fight, as it'll save you time, because if you choose to do this method, obviously, of fighting General Sargus Rook, run a frame, a speed frame, with a bit of tankiness. I'm running my Wukong, just so I can get there as quick as possible. And you need a decent rifle. I'm running Soma Prime, you can run anything really. My personal opinion, if you're a low MR and you're just trying to grind this up, use the Heck. It's a great shotgun that will be able to deal damage to him very easily if you just upgrade your point blank. So yeah, you should be able to deal easily enough damage to pretty much 2-3 shot each of his parts that you have to shoot. So yeah, there's three different phases pretty much, and phase one, you have to shoot his shoulder when he opens it, as you'll see me doing in a few minutes. Phase 2, you have to shoot his chest, so basically the blue parts. And then phase 3, he opens up a thing on his back. As you can see, that's the shoulder where you have to shoot. And his back, you just shoot him in the same spot again, on that back where it goes blue. So it's pretty much, you just see blue, you just spam it. And in between, when he does those phases, he'll just hit you with a load of fire. That's why having adaptation is a great positive to have for this boss fight. So you see me here, you know, I probably should have went with my Cito, just so I could have done the damage a lot quicker, but I chose my Soma. And yeah, he opens up that shoulder and you just gotta shoot him there. You see, he's gonna do it in the next few seconds. This is obviously pre-recorded. There you go, you see it kind of glows like that. That's what you're looking for, and then you shoot it. And you'll know once you've beat that stage, because his shoulder plating will just fall off, and that signifies you've beat that stage. Then you don't really know the difference between the second and third stage until you see him like do this other weird attack. But once you get used to the boss fight, this will be a very easy fight for you to do, and you can run through it very quickly. Personally, I've been farming up these Orokin cells for building up the frames and all the other stuff I have to do for mastery rank. And I know if I was a new player, or if I was a player who never really thought about grinding Orokin cells but wanted to know where to get them, this would be my go-to spot. If you want to guarantee it, definitely go here. As you can see in the second attack stage, he just kind of gets stuck in the ground and sets like the whole world on fire pretty much. But yeah, then he does this attack, which is where you hit him in the back. Once you do that, you kill him. And then just head to extraction, and you're pretty much finished. You can get, I think, anywhere from 1 to 4 Orokin cells. I know you can get a guaranteed 2, but I'm pretty sure you can get up to 4 if you get lucky. So yeah, make sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already. As you can see here, you can see I did get the Orokin cell at the end, and this is also the space to farm members. So.